One day I was drawing at a festival up south side of Chicago, and a fortune teller asked me if I would be willing to draw her portrait in exchange for a reading, and I said, I'll pass, I'm good. She insisted on, while I was setting up my stuff, still telling me my fortune. She struck out pretty much with everything she said. Ironically, through the weekend, she had long lines all day long. So anyway, would you want to know how your life will play out? It's one thing to plan for your future and even maybe even have a life coach help you be successful and achieve the things that you want. It's another thing to actually know. Jeremy Irons does a great job of telling this young man's fortune. It's a gothic fantasy style story, so it gets dark. The fortune's not a happy one, but you get the idea. And I would even argue that if I knew even the good that was going to happen in the future, I don't know that I'd want to know. I would want it to be a mystery. And part of, I think, the adventure of life and the beauty is the unknown. As we navigate and plan, set goals, develop our character, and create the best possible life that we could live. We'll watch this video clip and then we'll discuss it in class.
Lena, we have a guest.
He's leaving.
Hello, sir.
Manners, that's nice.
I go to school with Lena. I'm Ethan Wake. Pleasure to make your acquaintance.
You Lyle Evans' boy?
Yes, sir. You knew my mother?
Lena, why don't you ask your friend in for tea?
Tony can't stay.
I'd love to. Thank you, sir.
He's not scary.
Mr. Wake, make yourself comfortable.
Oh, I'm sorry about walking in uninvited before.
No problem at all. It's so rarely we get visitors from our beloved Gatlin.
Don't be a snob, Uncle. It's not their fault we never speak to any of them.
And it's not my fault that I have a predilection for good breeding, reasonable intelligence, and passable personal hygiene. But since my family founded this town, I have no alternative to call it home. So, there we are.
Oh, that's a beautiful piano.
Oh, yeah. Do you play?
No.
Lena, why don't you play something for our guest?
Because we're not in the Jane Austen novel.
Then why don't you go make us some tea?
Again, wrong century.
Well, then, would it disturb either of you if I ran my fingers across the ivories? I find it very therapeutic.
Uncle's upset. School called. He put me on probation until the window thing gets investigated.
That's crazy. That was not your fault.
Voice of reason in a town of buttermilk mines. Lee and I could get to like this friend of yours.
I mean, it's like blaming you for the lightning on Honey Hill.
Oh, yes, I heard about the lightning. In fact, a similar occurrence took place in Venezuela for many years at Lake Maracaibo. You can look it up on Google.
Uncle loves Google.
In any event, I'll sort it out with the school. But I understand your indignation, Ethan. Probation implies a source of authority. What is that source? A bunch of sexually frustrated housewives with minuscule minds and voluminous backsides. No, there's only two kind of people in Gatlin. The ones who are too stupid to leave and the ones who are too stuck to move.
My mother used to say that exact same thing.
Is that so? She was a lovely woman, your mother. I was so sorry to hear of her passing. Of course, I only knew her through her books. I read everything she wrote on the southern plantations. You plan on being a writer?
I don't know yet. Maybe.
What if I had a magic wand?
Macon.
And I could let you see your whole future. What would be there? And don't spare me the gory details.
Well, sir, I'm not sure. One thing I do know, though, is college. I'm definitely planning on going.
Oh, really? Where have you applied?
All of them. As long as they're not too far from home. I mean, as long as it's a local college. So I can stay with Dad. I'll get my teaching degree and probably teach at the high school. Or maybe I'll take over the library from Emma. I'll probably marry Emily Asher and we'll have two kids, but I'll never make enough money for her, so I'll start drinking. Get three DUIs and lose my job. And have an affair on and off with Savannah Snow till I'm 49. The kids will live with their mother after we divorce. Then when I'm 52, I'll have my first heart attack, another one at 63. I'll move into an apartment above the Wayward Dog Bar and help them sweep up after hours for free drinks. And then when I'm 64, I'll hang myself. But they won't find the body right away until I stink.
Well, you've got it all planned out. Good for you.
Ethan, are you okay?
Yeah, you'll have to excuse me. I've not been sleeping too well.